Hello, everyone. Here we have an example of projectile motion. A ball is thrown with an initial velocity of 12.4 meters per second at an angle of 36.1 degrees relative to the horizontal. It leaves your hand at positive 1.5 meters above the ground. When does it hit the ground? What was its maximum height? What was its speed when it passed your hand on the way down? And how far away from you did the ball land, i.e. the horizontal distance from the point of release? So let's start by sketching it out. Let's look at the Y versus X drawing, the 2D drawing. We've got the ball being released here at 1.5 meters with initial velocity of V0. So we'll have a projectile with a parabolic profile that goes like that and finally lands. And so the second thing to do is to break down the velocity into components, to resolve it into its components. So we've got that initial velocity of 12.4 meters per second, and we're going to resolve it into its x and y components. So that's simply a positive 12.4 meters per second times the sine of 36.1 degrees, which will give us a positive 7.3 meters per second. The x component is a positive 12.4 meters per second, but now times a cos of 36.1 degrees. And so there we get a positive 10.02 meters per second. Next, let's do a quick sketch of our position time curves. We'll break it down and we'll look at each of the y components and the x components for the position. We start off with an initial y0 of 1.5 meters, and we follow our parabolic trajectory, something like that. So we start off with an initial vy0, or a y component of the velocity, of positive 7.3 meters per second, where our v0 was a positive 12.4 meters per second. And we travel upwards to some y-max, at which point we know that Vy equals zero, and that happens at a time here, which we'll call the TM, when it reaches its maximum height. And we're also looking at this time, when it passes the hand again, and so at a Y position equal to positive 1.5 meters, but now on its way down. And lastly, we're interested in this time here, TG, when it hits the ground, in other words, when y equals zero. We're particularly interested in this time here, in terms of the x position. The x position starts at zero and has a steady slope up until that time when it runs out of time and it hits the ground. And so this position will be our maximum x position where it then hits the ground. And the slope of this is given by our vx, our x component of the velocity, and so it's 10.02 meters per second. And of course, the difference, or the distance that it's gone, is the delta xg that we're looking for in part four. But this should all be looking pretty familiar, because we've actually solved the first half of this problem before. We saw this problem before, where you toss a ball upwards at a positive 7.3 meters per second, leaving your hand at positive 1.5 meters, and we were asked to find when it hits the ground, its maximum height, and its speed when it passed your hand on the way down. There, we had an upward velocity of 7.3 meters per second. And now we have the same, but as a Vy component. So the component of our velocity that is vertical is 7.3 meters per second, just like we had there. But we now have an added constant x component to our velocity. In the context of solving the problem, then, Let's look here where we have it broken down into horizontal motion on the left and vertical motion on the right. We see the components that we worked out earlier. And I'll point out that the part of the problem we solved before is shown here in the box when we had the vertical motion in the Kinematics 1D example. When we determined the time of the vertical motion, we used this equation here, where we know the acceleration due to gravity. Make a small correction there. We knew the initial velocity, upward velocity. We knew the initial position at 1.5 meters, and we were trying to find the position when it hits the ground at y equal to zero. And using that equation, we found then that the total duration or time of flight was 1.7 seconds. Second, we found what was its maximum height from this equation here, where we again know the acceleration, we know the initial upward velocity, and we know that the velocity at the maximum height is equal to zero. And so we were able to find the maximum height as 4.2 meters. And that still applies here because we have the same upward component of the velocity. We were then asked what was its speed when it passed your hand on the way down, and we worked it out mathematically, but we saw that the symmetry gave you that while you had a positive 7.3 meters per second when it was launched from your hand, you then had a negative 7.3 when it passed that same position on the way down. Similarly here then, we will see that the speed, V naught, so the magnitude of our velocity, at the release from the hand at 1.5 meters will be the same as the speed at return to the hand at that same height. And so that speed will be 12.4 meters per second. So it'll be a positive 12.4 meters per second when it was launched, and the velocity will be a negative 12.4 meters per second when it passes the hand on the way down. So at those two same positions. But it asks for the speed here, so we're effectively just looking at the magnitude. And you can check that by recombining those, so I've broken them apart, but you can recombine what we have here of 10.02 and 7.3 meters per second, and they'll recombine, taking the square root of the squares of the components there, and you'll find that it's 12.4 meters per second. That'll check our math. Lastly, we're asked how far away from you did the ball land. So here's the part that's just a little bit of extra, it's an extension to the original problem, but you'll notice that all we're doing now is that we're filling in that Vx component from up above, because that's the velocity that it's using to travel in the x direction. And remember, it's Vy naught that buys us time. And so we're going to take the time from up here and plug it in. The total time of flight was 1.7 seconds. We plug that in and we get our total distance traveled. How far away from you did it fall? The total distance traveled is 17 meters. And so it's again just recognizing that these two-dimensional projectile motion problems are really two connected one-dimensional problems. We already did the first part of the 1D problem last week, and now we're just doing an extension of that. The Vy naught buys us time, and the Vx runs that out or goes the distance based on the time available, and we find out how far it went.